Okay, I got a pretty good question. Mr. T.
Just gave me a little pooper here.
Good boy, Mr. T. Good boy, Mr. T.
This is going to be interesting. The wind's blowing out here. He's filling his oats because it's early in the morning. It's cool. He's feeling excited. He's honking. He's not what I would say listening to me or paying attention to me. He's still listening to me. But he's not, if you notice, watch his head. He's looking around. He's nervous. His mare's out there. Buddy's over here crying. The wind's blowing. There's a lot of noise out here. This is increasing his fear. It's increasing his anxiety. So, I got a question that I thought was, of course, the answer is the same as all the questions. The question was, when is it abuse and when is it a correction? Or when does it change between discipline and abuse? It depends. It depends on the person. It depends on what happened. It depends on the situation. If you, I guess if I had to answer that, the answer would be it depends. But if you, I would say if you are upset, if you're acting out of emotion, if you're not being clear and direct and precise, and you're not giving release after you give the correction, it moves into abuse. Now, you know, the scale from abuse is huge, people. You know that there's the abuse story, you're tying a horse up with chains and beating him with a barbed wire whip. And then there's the one on the other end to where you're loving them to death and you're making them a dangerous animal, and that's abuse. Okay, people think just because I feed my horse and I groom him and I give him foot care and I put him in a barn at night and put a blanket on him when it's 100 degrees, that I love my horse, it's not abuse. It's still abuse in my book because you're making a horse non-functional in our domesticated society. Okay, if horses were wild, it wouldn't matter. And if they were free, it wouldn't matter. Then it would be abuse if you went out and chased them down and hurt them and shot at them and shot them with arrows and did stupid things like that.
What are you doing, Mr. G? Come over here, bud. I know all this big wind. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
So, where do you draw that line between abuse and a correction? Depends. I'm probably going to define abuse a little quicker than someone else. Most people aren't going to define abuse as, Rick, just because they braid their tail and nail shoes in their feet and make them stand in a stall in their urine and feces and their feet are rotting away and they get arthritis and their feet swell up, they call a vet and they give him his shots and they braid his tail and they give him good alfalfa hay. So that's not abuse. Well, in my mind it is. If I was a horse, I wouldn't like it. I'd hate it. It's a miserable life. People get too caught up in what I do for the horse and not what the horse needs. And there's a saying, I can't remember it specifically, but I've got it on my cowboy quotes or cowboy wisdom page, and it's something that love of a horse is more than fine stables and good grain. And the gist of it is, you just can't give food, water, and shelter to a horse and call that good care or good loving care. Now, the wind's blowing so stinking hard out here, I don't know if the camera's picking up or not. I know Mr. T's like, dude, the wind's blowing.
Mr. T, it's so scary. I know, I don't know what to do.
Now, you saw Mr. T when he lifted his head. I'm always trying to get people to realize that was confusion. That was, what do you want? You're raising both hands and you're talking loud and I don't know what you're saying and you're not telling me what to do. What do I do? Should I move? And when he got confused, kind of dropped his head and came in as soon as I gave him a little bit of release. You're always looking for that when you're doing horses. You want that horse to be able to come back to you. But I got to give release. If I just keep putting pressure, he's not going to figure out that's the right answer to come in and get me. I turn my back on him. He's more relaxed now than he is now. Everybody see the difference in that? See the difference in Mr. T's a good trainer. This is relax. This is release. This is human not in my face. This is I'm taking care of myself. What I'm about to do is love.
Oh, Mr. T, I just love you so. You're such a good boy. I love you, Mr. T.
All right, people get that? See the difference? I know it's hard to tell. Mr. T's not a good teacher. He's a... Now, you see the difference in Mr. T because you see the difference in me? You see how I've given him release? And this, Mr. T is telling me, I'm okay with this. I can accept this. You're not in my face. You're not being loud. You're not pushing me. You're not moving quick. You're not confusing me. You're not trying to be a predator and grabby. I'm giving him a little release. I'm still rubbing him. I'm touching him. If I get him to drop his head, does he love me? No. He heard me. Did you see that? He knew I was going to reach up there and do that. I always say horse knows what's going to happen before it happens. So when I said H-E-A-D, he was like... So I'm going to reach up here and have him lower his head. Does that mean he loves me? No. It means he knows what I want. I'm being clear. Head. 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 Oh, Rick, he loves you. Oh, look, he's trying to give you a hug. He loves you. He's listening. He's a cue. He's finding comfort because I do it enough. So back to abuse. If you correct a horse and you understand when you're correcting him that you want a right answer, that you've got a goal, that you're trying to get a different response than you got, it's a correction. If I correct a horse because I'm mad, because I'm upset, because I'm going to show him who's boss, because I'm trying to impress everybody that's watching that I'm tough cowboy, cowgirl, I'm going to show this horse who's boss and I'm tough and I'm bad, and then it's abuse. Now, again, there's different levels of abuse. Does that kind of abuse hurt a horse? It hurts him mentally. It makes him less prepared to survive. I like my horses to be able to accept things and to live in an environment that we have domesticated and made in our social society, so they have a better chance. Mr. T didn't have a chance, and I've talked about this before. Abuse, several owners, three strikes, crazy, needs to be put down, is going to kill somebody. All that could be true. If I gave him a bunch of dummies, which is no shortage of, and they went out there and tried to handle him, when he threw his head up and did all that, they would be, oh, I don't want to scare him. Let me just be quiet and nice. And the next thing you know, Mr. T be like, man, I got these humans figured out. I'm going to start kicking him and biting him and treating him like a lower herd. And then they would be saying, oh my God, they were right. Mr. T is a dangerous, mean, wild Mustang. And he does probably need to be put down because he's going to kill somebody. No, he's going to kill your dumb butt because you don't know what you're doing. And that's the same way with all horses. They're a reflection of the people. Again, developing that critical eye. Stop blaming the horse. When you see horses do things, look at the person and say, what are they doing to cause this horse to do this? And what should they be doing to get the horse to stop doing what he's doing? Is it a correction? Is it more direction? Is it blocking the wrong answer? I'm going to move Mr. T, and I'm going to move him with communication and feel. And if he pays attention, we're going to do it nice, soft, and easy. If he doesn't, I'm going to turn up the heat and I'm going to correct him or abuse him, some people will say, because I'm going to say, you know what, I don't put up with that. So let's see if he's going to pay attention. Now, Mr. T moved in a very soft walk. I stopped talking. I gave him direction. I moved my body. My focus went moved this way, and he did it. Now, could I have done that same thing in a different way? Yes. I'm going to show you. You better move when I tell you. You move when I tell you, mister. Who do you think you are? I'm a horse trainer. You're going to listen. There. Showed that horse. Stupid horse. You got to show this horse who's boss, people. That's how you handle a horse. Okay? Does everybody see how upset Mr. T is right now? Was that abuse? Some people may say it was abuse. It was unnecessary. Did it hurt Mr. T? No. Did it confuse him? Yeah, he's confused. He's like, what the heck? Dude, what are you doing? Because I moved for you softly. If I did that all the time, would I screw him up? Yes. If I did that all the time and that's the only thing I ever used on him, would he be a freakazoid all the time? Yes. But can I bring him back down? He's breathing hard right now. Can I make him go, dude, I don't know what your problem is, but I just want to get along. Horses want to get along. They want to give you the right answer most of the time. unless you've trained them to disrespect you, to ignore you, to not listen to you, to always nag at them so they never know what you want, to always want to be in their face and handle them, but you never give them direction or give them release, so they never know what the right answer is. Come here, Mr. T. I know. Dad's sorry. I know.
Dad's a big meanie. Dad's a big meanie. I know. Come on, Mr. T.
So, guess we'll end that there. Hope that helps. And,
I don't know.
What's abuse? What's kindness? You be the judge.